Hey folks, Armin Hammer here, and we're going to take a quick recap of day one at Strength and Depth, as well as a look at what to expect for day two. Let's get to it. First and foremost, I think it's very important to point out that the Strength and Depth live stream is really, really good. They have commentary on the top heats of every division, as well as a free high quality stream that you can watch both on their Facebook as well as on their website. It seems to be ad supported. Last I checked, when I was just watching this morning, the very tail end of the entire day's worth of streaming, they're just over 2,200, 2,300 people watching at that moment, which I think probably had peaked even higher during the day. So we're really looking at a successful launch for their broadcast. I was really pleasantly surprised. They had really good graphics. Obviously, there's some things that are missing that happened with the games and regionals, like rep counters, for example. But that type of technology is pretty expensive, but also already exists thanks to CrossFit's ability to have that happen at the games. So I think down the line, as I'd said in one of my previous videos, we're gonna start seeing very quickly the quality of these top-end events catch up on in terms of the broadcast. But let's take a look at the action. So 19.1 was actually the very first workout of the event for all these competitors. They had slated in 19.1 without exactly knowing what it was, and I think they did a really good job of actually giving the athletes an opportunity to, one, log a good score, and use the environment to actually put up really impressive performances. In fact, we saw on the men's side, two athletes actually get into their 11th round. So finishing 10 rounds and then getting into the wall ball on the 11th round. And those athletes, those were Roman Krennikov and Elliot Simmons. And that's really impressive. On the women's side, Sarah Sigma's daughter did a great job on 19.1. And she's someone that I'm gonna be mentioning a little bit, you know, pretty regularly, you know, talking about the first day of Strength and Depth, because she's an athlete that we've been watching for a long time. She had to withdraw from the 2018 games with a rib injury and has essentially been building herself back up from the ground up, and has been doing a great job with showings that were top tier at Dubai and now at Strength and Depth. The other three events of the day were really interesting. The event two was a triplet that included bar muscle ups, handstand walking, and dumbbell snatches. Event three and four happened back to back, and event three was a max snatch. Event four was this sprint on the assault bike, followed by Grace. And I think really I want to focus on event three and four, that combination, because what we saw on the women's side was Sarah Sigmund's daughter, absolutely impressive performance. She snatched 95 kilos, which I believe is a competition PR for her, and something that, you know, she was able to do having come off of just 8-9 months ago a rib injury that pulled her out of the games. So the fact that she's not only back but also better than she has been in the past, certainly better than she was at the 2017 games in terms of a one rep max snatch, I think it's important to focus on that fact, and then combine that with the performance on that event four. That was a first place finish on event four, 2:39 to do 20 cal assault bike followed by Grace. That's a really impressive combination. It certainly is something that you would expect to see someone like classic Sarah Sigmund's daughter really show up and throw down. Other than Sarah Sigmund's daughter, however, the top women at Strength and Depth are putting together a show that really has been reminiscent of how good the women's competition has been so far in the past 5 years or so of the CrossFit Games. And what we're looking at is Dani Spiegel and Sarah Sigmund's daughter and Jamie Green essentially putting together this really crazy race between the three of them for who is gonna win this thing at the end of day two. Now, none of those names should be a surprise. We saw Sarah and Jamie and Dani, all three of them, compete at Dubai. All three of them do incredibly well over there. We saw Dani compete at Wadapalooza individually and really show up hard as well in that field. Jamie Green competed on a team that won at Wadapalooza. So these are athletes that are really, you know, focusing in on the new version of this season and this early portion of the season as an opportunity to get their competitive engine revving in a way that we haven't really seen a lot of top-end athletes utilize events for in the past. In the past, usually these events would be either ignored by or really lower level athletes at that top echelon would be attending it in any way, shape, or form. But now, athletes that are essentially like staking their claim for a spot at the CrossFit Games are using these events to consistently show up and throw down at a high level, and that is really impressive. On the men's side, what we've seen is actually something really fascinating, which is of the known athletes, Alex Smith and Willie George, two favorites going into this thing, both have withdrawn from the competition early on, and none of the named athletes that are remaining are actually pushing for a podium spot after the first day. In fact, the three athletes at the top of this field, none of them have been to the games before. At the top of the leaderboard is probably an athlete you've never heard of. I know I had not heard of him before. This is Bronislav Olenkovits, who is an athlete clearly on the power end of the spectrum when it comes to CrossFit, because his performances in the first two events were respectable, but not great. His performance in the last two events of day one were kind of bananas. We're talking in the max snatch event, he snatched 308, and in the calorie assault bike grace event, he was the last one off of the assault bike and finished first overall. It was really an impressive performance, and essentially, you know, he was deadlift to reverse curl to strict press all 30 of those reps in grace. On the team side, it looks like we might be having a sweep, actually. The Central Beasts team has won 4 for 4 of the events so far, and with 3 events remaining tomorrow, even if they, you know, maybe make a couple of mistakes, it looks like they've locked up that win. And the two athletes that I think are notable on this team are the women. It's Nicole Holcomb, who is a 2-time CrossFit Games athlete on the individual side, and Emma Chapman, who, while she hasn't made the games individually, was 8th at regionals last year and is the Tough Mudder X world champion. I don't know if you guys remember Tough Mudder X. It was an event that's kind of like this shorter end of the obstacle course sprint world, and it had a whole bunch of CrossFit Games athletes showing up for that. I think Jacob Heppner was there, Fellner was there, Sam Dancer was there. On the women's side, Emma Chapman was the champion. She cashed that big check, she showed up, and she won. It was really impressive. So going into day two, there's 3 events remaining, and you know, one of them is a slightly longer sort of like conditioning chipper type event with a pyramid rep scheme. Another one is this combination of running and deadlifts and toes to bar. And then the last event is this really short sprint combination of rope climbs and heavy thrusters. And it's not gonna be, you know, like a 3-minute workout, but it's certainly gonna be a shorter, heavier workout. But on the men's side, I really wanna focus on Roman Krennikov, who right now is not in the top 3, but is certainly within striking distance of the points. Now, you know, we saw a huge points gap occur after the, you know, 1 rep max snatch into the assault bike plus grace workout that favored the high power output guys. And I think all 3 of the events coming up on the final day of competition at Strength and Depth, none of those are gonna be favoring the high power output guy. And almost all of them are gonna be favoring the redonkulous engine dude, which happens to be Roman Krennikov. And he's the guy that I would keep my eye on to make a big push going into the final day. Hopefully, there's still enough points left on the table for him to be able to, you know, really, you know, solidify what we've all wanted to see out of him, which is this dude won Europe last year, qualified for the CrossFit Games and wasn't able to come compete, and, you know, kind of has left everyone on the edge of their seat to see what he can do when he makes it back to the big show. On the women's side, going into day two, there's 20 points between Sarah Sigmundsdottir in first place and Jamie Green in second place, but there are only 2 points between Jamie Green and Danny Spiegel in third place, and that really just sets the table for an explosive final day at Strength and Depth. Between these 3 events, none of them particularly favor one athlete over another. I would say the higher skill, higher gymnastics type stuff, that's all gone. Day two at Strength and Depth is essentially a power output festival. It's just a look at who can crush themselves through these events as efficiently as possible. And when Sarah Sigmundsdottir was being interviewed at the end of the first day, she essentially said that 4 events on day one is too easy. So if she's going to be able to back that up, which we have no reason to not think that she can, that is going to put her in a position with a lead in the second day to just expand that lead even further. Now, that's not to say that Jamie Green and Danny Spiegel cannot catch up, but certainly they are going to have their work cut out for them. Remember, folks, there's a whole lot going on in our sport, and it's easy to miss some of the most interesting and exciting stories. I just wanted to say before I go, just last week, I feel like I thanked everybody for getting us to 10,000 subscribers, and I'm already basically knocking on the door of 12,000 subscribers, and I cannot thank you guys enough. This is what I love to do. I'm lucky to get to do it. Hopefully, you guys are getting as much out of it as I am, and I really appreciate the fact that we can have this open conversation and talk to one another about all this crazy stuff that's going on, because I'll be honest with you, it's as crazy to me as I'm sure it is to you, and hopefully I'm able to maybe present different perspectives as well as, you know, give yourself a little bit of analysis coming into what could be a very confusing time for our sport. If you do like this content, if you love this stuff, if you like talking about this and hearing about it, please, the best way to show your support, like it, share it, subscribe it, tell your friends about all of the stuff that you're hearing from me and where you're hearing it from, and all together we're gonna make this thing grow. Thank you so much, folks, and I'll see you guys next time.